Okay, so we have a new Falcon model out. This is the Falcon 180B, again made by the Technology Innovation Institute of Abu Dhabi. And they've announced a new model, and they're claiming that this new model is a rival beating Llama 2, the 70 billion Llama 2 model, and also basically rivaling with Google's Palm 2 and ChatGPT, I guess, and some of the other models that are around that. So let's jump in and have a look at some stats about the actual model. So they've put the model up on Hugging Face for you to be able to look at this. More interestingly, though, Hugging Face has actually done a whole blog post about this model, and they've got some interesting things in here. And they're talking about that the model is trained on 3.5 trillion tokens, and it actually comes from a refined web data set. So that's kind of interesting. We need to look into that maybe a little bit more in the future. They claim that this represents the longest single epoch pre-training for an open model. So this is an interesting fact that people have been looking at, is do we go for a smaller data set and train it for multiple epochs, or do we just try and find a data set that's so big that we can fit it all in one epoch in here? Now, as I mentioned before, they're claiming that this is a rival to proprietary models like Palm 2, that it beats a lot of the open source models that are out there. So let's have a look at some of those facts. Okay, so what is the Falcon 180B model? So as I mentioned earlier, the model's been trained for 3.5 trillion tokens on 4,096 GPUs simultaneously using Amazon for a total of around 7 million GPU hours. So they don't mention the cost, but my guess is it's probably 100s that they've used to train this. With the bulk discounts and stuff like that, you're probably looking at around $2 per A100 per hour at the moment. So you're looking at probably at least $14 million to train this model, unless they've gotten some fantastic deal from AWS in using SageMaker there. They mentioned that the Falcon B is 2.5 times larger than Llama 2 and is trained with 4 times as much compute as Llama 2, which is very interesting. One of the things that, if you remember back to when the Llama 2 models came out, that even at 2 trillion tokens, the loss was still clearly going down. So there's been a lot of rumors, a lot of people proposed that perhaps Meta actually kept training that model for another trillion tokens or longer. We know, for example, the code Llama was trained on another 500 billion tokens of just code for that. So it does show that even with these models, we're not really near exhausting any sort of plateau of the loss going down and the models getting better. It does show that, you know, training for 3.5 trillion tokens is something that is going to be very interesting with these kind of models. The rumors are that Palm 2 has been trained for 3.6 trillion tokens. I don't know how true that is, but that's a fact that's sort of out there on the interwebs somewhere. Another point that they mentioned here in the blog post is the whole idea of the commercial use of Falcon 180B. From what I've seen, looking at the actual license, that basically what they're trying to do is block companies and startups from being an API provider of this model. So the license allows you to use it, but it doesn't allow you to then set up an API endpoint to sell this. So in some ways, I guess it blocks companies like Together, like Replicate, like some of the, you know, perhaps even Hugging Face from doing some of those things, which honestly, I kind of feel is totally fair that they would do this. Some other things in the license, just looking at it, is that if you make a derivative work or a fine tune of this model, they want to be acknowledged for the money and the effort that they've put into actually making this, which again, I think is totally justified for doing this. So let's look at some of the stats for this, because I think this is where it opens up a whole bunch of interesting things about, are we seeing some tricks that are being done on proprietary models and on models in big companies that are not necessarily being talked about publicly? And I think the answer to that is yes. And I'll explain a little bit as we go through here. So you would expect that if this is 4 times the amount of compute, 2.5 times bigger, that this is going to do a lot better, right? Yet when we look at the Hugging Face leaderboard, we can see that it's only slightly better than Llama 2. So this is their average score of the leaderboard. In fact, let's jump in and have a look at the leaderboard. So here's the Hugging Face open LLM leaderboard. If we come down and we look for the 180 model, we can see we actually have to come down quite a way to find this model, right? So this is something, you know, interesting that there's already a lot of other fine-tuned models, admittedly, that are doing better on this. So this either one reflects badly on the Hugging Face leaderboard, that basically people perhaps are fine-tuning on what they're testing on or things like that. I'm not sure that's necessarily the truth for all the models. I certainly don't think it's true for all the models, perhaps for some. But the biggest story that I think that this shows is the whole concept of data curation and things like curriculum learning. So we've seen groups of people like the Wizard LM guys with their Evol Instruct method being able to get much better boost in scores for things like the Code Wizard or Wizard Coder 34B recently, which was able to do a massive bump over the Code Llama model with just using the same model, but then fine-tuning on perhaps the right data to make it more better for this. If we think back to when GPT-3 sort of took off as ChatGPT, right, the 3.5 models, we kind of know that a lot of that was to do with very good instruction fine-tuning and perhaps also some elements of RLHF or RLAIF. Although I'm a little bit suspicious of how much RLHF actually contributed to a lot of the results that we saw. It does seem that just doing instruction fine-tuning with these models, and most of these are just some kind of fine-tuning in here. I don't think many of them are actually even using RLHF. We can see if we look at this blue dot, I'm not seeing any here that, okay, there's one that's basically got RLHF. Now that could be because people are not publicly disclosing it, could be for a variety of reasons. But certainly when we look at this, there's a lot of these Orca models, a lot of these models with very heavily curated data sets that seem to be scoring bigger for this. Now, where we can look at the brute power of this model is to come and look at the MMLU scores. So sure enough, on MMLU, this is doing 70, where a lot of these other models are doing less than that, or perhaps, you know, close to. But again, don't forget that this model is 2.5 times bigger than that. So I'm very curious to see what we get from the fine tunings of this Falcon 180B. It would be very interesting to see what the Wizard LLM guys do with this and what some of the other people who are doing a lot of the fine tunings manage to get out of this to see, okay, can this base model be improved to be on the standard of a GPT-4 or something like that? I do suspect that OpenAI has some very nice tricks in relation to curriculum learning and how they're basically handling the data for the actual pre-training phase as well. And I think a lot of those tricks probably being used at OpenAI, at Google DeepMind, at Meta to some degree as well. I think the Llama 2 paper kind of showed that as well, as in what wasn't talked about sometimes as opposed to what was talked about in there. So jumping back in here, we can see some more stats about the Falcon 180B. The best thing is to just jump in and have a play with it. And this is where we see the Falcon 180B chat is what you can actually play with. So it's interesting that they're actually taking this chat model and they've basically fine-tuned on some of these data sets that are publicly available. So it's interesting that they haven't trained on the Evol Instruct data sets, but they have trained on some of the other data sets that people have been using for fine-tuning quite a lot lately. So that's something interesting to look at. They mentioned here that, you know, this is a first experimental preview and that going forward, you know, they will perhaps improve this with data sets, with RLHF, with RLAIF as well. Anyway, let's have a play with it. Okay, so in a little over a week and a bit, I'm going to be back in San Francisco. Let's see if we ask it, you know, what's good to see in San Francisco and see what it is basically saying. Now, I'm surprised that actually they're getting results very quickly for the model. So clearly Hugging Face is running quite a number of A100s to run this. Okay, so it's just giving me a list there. Plan me 3-day tour. Unfortunately, I'm not going to have any time to do a tour, but let's see what it can come up with. And we can see that it's generally just suggesting all the sort of cliche things of San Francisco. Okay, so if I ask it, what is one thing that I should see that is unusual and most people don't see? looking for something unique and off the path. It's definitely giving us good answers to this. I'm not sure at this stage, it's not so easy to say that this is better than one of the fine-tuned Llama 2s or something like that. Really, we'd want to run it through a bunch of different reasoning and logic stuff like GSM, AK, etc. What I suggest is that you have a play yourself, check it out. You can see how it is for your users. Running this model locally is going to be pretty hard. So Hugging Face has basically put up some stats of what they're seeing. That basically, you need 64 A100s to do a full fine tuning of it. If you want to do a LoRa fine tuning, you're looking at around 16. If you're doing a 4-bit QLoRa fine tuning, you're looking at around 2 A100 ADGs. And then for inference, you know, my guess is that they're probably running on 8 or 16 of the A100 80 gigabytes for this inference speed here. Interestingly, there are 4-bit GPT-Q models out, although even those, it seems like you're not going to be able to run that on your local computer anytime soon. They've got some information about the prompt format in here and some info about how to run it and how to run the different 8-bit and 4-bit models in. As always, I'll put the links in the description so you can check it out, see how you find it, have a play with it yourself. Please leave me some comments and let me know, you know, what you think of the model itself and any interesting flaws or things that you notice in the model. I think we've gotten to the point now where testing these models is much better done by groups of people at scale than one person putting in some standard prompts or something. Another thing that I've discovered recently is that the prompts that I used to use a lot, people have started training on those prompts. So it makes them null and void for this. Anyway, as always, if you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.